bubble sort also we have executed. So quickly just do one thing. Let me do one thing that let me share my screen. Wait, guys, just let me share my screen. Let me record this meeting because the network is very slow actually today, so it is troubling me very much. So please bear with me, guys. But today we have to see some of the concepts related to Unit 5. Okay, Jahnavi, are you here? Jahnavi, are you here? Or Akash, any one of you? Jahnavi or Akash, can you please respond if you are here? No one is here. Akash, can you please leave a message in your group, please? Because ask them once again to join the class, because we are going to discuss some of the concepts in Unit 5 today. So at least you listen. It would be a better, no? It would be better, right? Right? So please ask them to join. Yeah, fine. See, guys, is this screen visible? Yes, right? See, this Unit 5 is entirely related to graphical user interface applications. That is, so far we have discussed console-based applications. What are console-based applications? Suppose if we create a class, there are some methods, we just created some objects. Based on the objects, we used to call those methods. And we used to compile and execute that program on the console. Yes or no? And we will see the output even on the console itself. But they are console-based applications. But now, this Unit 5 is related to the graphical user interface applications, GUI-based applications. Okay, what is graphical user interface applications? Graphical user interface applications means some graphics, just like that. See here. There is some window, right? Right? There is some window. On this window, we are able to see some of the text boxes, some of the buttons. Yes or no? Did you observe? Understood? Yes? So whatever the application we are able to write, that application output we can see on the some of the container. Just like an applet. So I'll tell you what is an applet I'll discuss, don't worry. So far, one thing you have to understand is, so far we have done console-based applications. Now we are going to deal with the graphical user interface applications. And please look at this. That is the GUI. Read this. GUI, it is made up of graphical components. through which the user can interact with the application. The user want to interact with the application. So how he can able to interact with the application? Through some buttons he can able to interact, through some labels, through some windows he can able to interact. So that components, with that components we can able to interact with the application of the application. Okay, and see, this is the container. This entire thing is a container. See, this border, everything is a container. In that container we have, listen carefully, there are two types of GUI elements. What are they? Component and container. Components are elementary GUI entities such as button, label and text field. Okay, these are the components. Text field and buttons are the components. And what are the containers? Containers are such as frame and panel. See, whenever I want to keep some components on your application, I need a frame. I need some place to keep them. Yes or no? That place which on top of that where you have to keep that label, text field and buttons, that is what the frame or else or a panel. See, look at this carefully. This entire thing is a frame. This container is entire thing is a frame. In that frame we have two separated panels. Understood? No, panels, that is partitions. On each panel, what we have kept? We have kept one of the component. What is the component I have kept here? What is the component I have kept here? This one. Can you able to see my cursor pointer? Yes, text field. And the second panel, on the second panel, what are all the components we have kept? Can you please tell me? Second panel, second partition, buttons. Very good. On the first component, first panel, I have kept text field component. In the second panel, I have kept buttons components. Understood? No? So we will have some container. On that container, we will keep some components to interact with your application. Did you understand this, everybody? Did you understand this statement? Did you understand? Everyone. Is there any confusion? No, right? Yeah, very good, Abhinav and Daniel. Yeah, fine. So this is what we have learned, that is container and the component. And this complete theory you can read it later, because whatever I have discussed, that is what is there here. And this is coming to the programming section. That is, suppose if you want to create a panel. Suppose if you want to create a panel, this is how you have to create a panel. Suppose if you want to create a button, because these are predefined classes, button, panel, etc., etc., container. These are the predefined classes. So you just make use of them by creating an object. Okay, everything is there. Everything is there. Buttons are there. Text fields are there. All the panels are there. The containers are there. So everything is there. Just you need to create an object and you have to use in the program. Understood? No? See, here I just created a panel like this, and also I have created an object of the button. Okay, button. Understood? On button, it is taking a parameter press. That what does it mean? What does it mean? On button, what text you can find out? Press. Yes or no? That is what the meaning here, no? Understood or not? Button is a component. Panel is a container. Panel is a container to contain the components. Yes? And how I am adding to the button to the panel? How I am adding that button, the specified button to your container? Panel dot add of this one. This is one. Panel object. On panel object, I can call the add method and I can pass the button object so that the panel container adds a button on the component. Understood? Very good. See, the top level containers are, we just discussed the containers, no? we just discuss the containers, the space provided, the space provide. You can see once again, containers such as frame and panel used to hold the components. That containers are basically frame and also dialogue and also applet. Okay, frame, dialogue, and applet. What is an applet? I'll tell you. Just 2 minutes later. Okay. Each GUI program has top level container. Commonly used top level containers are AWT or frame, dialogue, and applet. See, there are two things: AWT and swings. Suppose if you want to develop any GUI applications, there are two things you can able to make use of. That is AWT and swing. What is AWT? Abstract Window Toolkit. Here also every components we have, all the components we have, text fields, buttons, etc. components we have. But AWT is a deprecated version. What is deprecated version? We have used this term even in the unit 4. Deprecated version means not copy. They are old versions. These AWT concepts are superseded by applets. Superseded by swings. That is, the latest version of the GUI applications, we can able to use these swings. And these AWT are deprecated versions. Deprecated version means suppose we have some utility classes, no? What are the utility classes we have hash table, dictionary, vector, legacy classes. Actually, they are deprecated versions. That is, and also enumerator is also deprecated. Enumeration also deprecated. And enumeration is superseded with iterator. Understood? No. So in the world versions, they have used AWT. Now it is superseded with. Now it is not replaced. But on top of the AWT, swings were used on top of AWT. It is not replaced completely. On top of AWT, swings are able to be constructed. Understood? Okay. What is AWT? We will see. Okay. What is AWT? Abstract Window Toolkit. And AWT uses what type of containers? Frame, dialogue, and also applet. Okay, we will mainly concentrate on applet. See, these are the theory and all you just read later. But I'm explaining by looking at this. Okay. This is frame. This complete thing is a frame. This whatever the figure you can able to see here, this is a frame. On this frame, you have a menu bar, you have a content pane like this you have. And these are the window buttons. This is a title and icon. They are mentioning some parts of the components of the frame here. Okay. These are the components, component classes, buttons, labels, checkboxes, checkbox groups. Okay, list you have, choice you have, text field you have. These are the components classes. Understood? No, these are the classes available to make your components. Understood, guys? Everybody understood? These are the containers. See, these are the containers and these are the components. All these are components. Understood or not? What I'm saying is, did you understand? Graphical user interface applications ni build up cheyali ante AWT aina kavali, swings anna kavali. AWT anedi deprecated version. Now we are mainly using swings. And swings also in real time, if you want to talk about, even swings also not using much, but they are using some other things. But still related to our syllabus, we have to learn those things, AWT and swings a little. Okay, so understood everybody? So AWT provides some part of the containers. Containers, already I told you, the space on which we can hold the components. What are the containers we have in AWT? Frame, dialog, and applet. And what are the components classes we have? Text field, choice, checkbox, buttons, labels, list. These are the components which we can keep on the container, any applet container. Understood? Understood or not so far? At least a little. Yes, Shravya. Yes. Only Shravya, Anil, and Rohit, and 61 and 6W understood. What about the others? Abhinav. Okay, fine. Check once more. Yeah. See, guys. So far, you understood, no? Listen. This is the hierarchy of classes. This is the hierarchy of classes, in which you can able to find the GUI application related classes. See, what is this object? Object is the super class, not class. It's a super class of all the classes. Okay. Super class of all the classes. And from object, which class is derived? Component. From this component class, we have several derived classes, several child classes. What are they? Button, label, checkbox, choice, list, container. These are the different classes we can able to derive from the component class. Okay, and just a second, guys. So from component class, component is a class. From this we have several, these are the classes we have, and container is also a subclass of component. And here in container, what else we have? What are the derived classes? Window and panel. From panel we have one more class, is the child class, is applet. Okay, applet. And from window, frame and dialog. Understood? No? Understood? Just keep that structure in mind. No need to butterfly. Just keep that structure, hierarchy structure in your mind. Okay? From object, component. From component, we have several components like button, label, checkbox, etc. Container. From container, we have window and panel. From window, we have applet. From window, we have frame and dialog. From panel, we have applet. Is derived so far. Understood? Right? Yes or no? Okay. So here you can study. I'll forward this. It is already uploaded in the Tessellator study material tab. You just download. You just have a glance and read once. That's it. Read once and understand. That's it. No need to by heart, like nothing. Okay. And the window we have seen. Window is also a container. Panel is also a container. Frame is also a container. Okay. And we have the several methods they have discussed. Okay. And these are the labels. How the constructors they have used in the labeled AWT class. Okay. And the label class has three constructors, and they have give the description over here. Okay. And you can see the several methods and the sample program also you have. Sample programs also you have, you can easily understood. You can understood very easily. Don't worry, okay? You can understood very easily based on the above description, right? And the text area, these are the components actually. Differences between text field and text area you can see. And so that's it. You can see each class, you can button class, how button is, how to add that, what are the constructors we have. You can see just over there. And we will discuss right now applet. We will discuss right now applet. I already told you, no, what is applet? What is applet? What is applet? Just now we have discussed, no, applet, frame and all are related to container. Very good. Applet is a container, frame is a container. Yes or no? So these are the containers in AWT. Okay, abstract window toolkit. And what is the swing? Swing is also it's an API, application program interface to create graphical user interface applications or as window based applications. Okay, it's an API. Swing is also an API which creates window based applications or graphical user interface applications. Okay, understood now? And Swing is built on top of AWT. Swing is built on top of AWT. Okay. And let me go back to our programs. So that through programs, I want to explain what is an applet. Okay. And mainly before going to that, what I want to tell you is, before let me open that and I'll let me explain that. Okay, let me open this. What is that? See, from here I want to explain actually. Okay, yes, are you able to see this? Are you able to see this? Yes, see. Applet, actually why we are using, what is an applet? What is an applet is, it is a special type of program. Okay, it's a program, it's an application program, it's an application program interface. I already, it's an API, it's a program that is embedded in the web page. Okay, there are some web pages, no? Did you see any web pages? Some of the web pages you already, somehow you come across in your daily life. Yes or no? Yes? In that web pages, we will just embed this small program, applet program, so that it can able to generate dynamic content. Listen carefully, guys. Applet can able to generate dynamic content. I'll tell you one example. See, suppose whenever you are reading something in your you are reading something Java site, you might have approach. Suppose Java T point, for example. In Java T point, of course you are studying some concept in that. You will find out some of the ads just beside of your web page. Some part of your web page, there are some ads. Some square boxes like that. Did you observe? Yes. Yes or no? Sometimes, as and when we are reading, there are many things are keep on changing dynamically. The content is changing in that particular box. Did you observe that? Sometimes it is talk about something. Sometimes it is talking about the about A. Sometimes it is talking about something B. It is adding. They are giving ads on different things. Yes or no? Dynamically, it is changing. Right? Did you observe ever? Everybody? Everyone. I'm asking everyone. Yes? Hmm. Guys, are you able to listen my voice? Is it audible? So in that web page, the part of that ads, the part which on which you can see the ad, that we can able to relate to an applet. So it is a program which will be embedded on the web page to create the dynamic content. Please read along with me. Please tell me along with me. Please tell everybody. You can say along with me. Applet is a special type of program. Okay, that is embedded on the web page to create, to generate dynamic content. Okay, and one thing you need to remember is applets are embedded at the server side. Generally, they are embedded at the server side, but whenever you want to execute them, they will be downloaded to your client machine. And on the client, in the client itself, they are going to be executed. Okay, actually, they are embedded in the server. And then whenever you want to execute, they will be downloaded to your machine, client machine, and they will execute on your machine. Okay, understood? Did you understand what I am saying? They will work at client machine. Okay, understood or not, everybody? Did you understand this point or not? Yes or no? I'm sorry. Servlets. Okay, you are relating this thing to servlets. Okay, you just that is somewhat actually something is which is different. Of course, servlets are working at the server side. Of course, you will come to that concepts in the next year. Okay, till now. At present, what you need to understand is applet is a program which will be embedded in the server side, and whenever you want to execute that will be downloaded to your client machine so that you can execute that on client machine. Then what are the advantages of the applet? The advantages of the applet is as it is working on the client machine, the response time is very less. Understood or not? Response time is less means it is there in our machine, no? It is downloaded to our machine, no? So the response time to communicate with that applet is that response time is very less, and also it is secured. And also one thing I want to tell you is the applets are written in Java. Okay, applets are written in Java. Okay, so that you can able to execute them on any machine like Linux machine, any different kind of OS, Linux or Windows or Ubuntu, anything. Okay, or Mac OS. So on any kind of platform, you can able to use the applet. Okay, understood or not? Understood? Yes or no? Applets are written in Java language so that you can use on any platform. They are platform independent. They are secure. Yes or no? They are able to respond in a very less time. So these are the advantages you have related to applets. Okay. And still, we will come back to our program once. So I already told you, applet is available in the applet package. This is the class actually. Applet, capital Applet is the class, applet class, which is available in the applet package. Applet package. And one more thing I want to tell you guys, why I have imported awt.graphics, I'll tell you a bit later. Okay, understood? Graph. Okay, just for right now you need to understand applet is a class which is available in the applet class, applet package. Okay, I'll tell you this later. Just understand now, class app one, app one extends applet. Suppose if you want to create a thread, what you will do? Suppose if you want to create a thread class, what you will do? You make that class. How will you create extended from thread class? You make that class to be extended from thread class. Suppose if you want to define user defined exceptions. Suppose if you want to create user defined exceptions, how will you do that? Suppose class example one extends exception, capital E exception, so that as it is extending from suppose thread class, the class is a thread class. Now here also, as this class app1 is extended from applet, now I can say that app1 is a applet class which can able to create the applets. Now app1 can have the ability to create applets. Okay, understood? No, what now can you please tell me what is an applet? Applet is a special kind of program which can be embedded in the server side and will be downloaded to the client machine, works on client's machine. Understood? Can you able to remember that? I'll ask you again in the next class, so you have to answer, right? Now this applet is also have its own life cycle. Applet got even that? What it is having? Applet is having a, what it is having? Just now I told you, it's have its own life cycle. Can you able to remember thread life cycle? I'll ask you one question. What are the states of a thread life cycle? List out quickly. Can you able to list out the states of your life thread class life cycle states? Already you have given. Very good. Rohit and Jagadish, Abhinav and Anil. That is, first with Jagadish, it starts with what? Jagadish, you are a little, the terms are not apt. They are not apt. Okay. Look at the Abhinav's, not Abhinav's. Anil. No, Anil is not. It's not also pro, it is not even proper. New, ready, running, exactly. 68. What's your name, 68? What's your name? Bhavani. Yeah, very good, Bhavani. Excellent. See, as Bhavani said, the states are five. New, ready. Ready means runnable. Runnable or ready? Anything you can say. New, first one is new, second ready or runnable, third running, fourth is blocked or waiting state, blocked state, and finally it is terminated state or dead state. Okay, there are five states in your thread life cycle. Okay, see, many of you have mixed, you just have mixed like anything. Okay, just please do remember, you just have to recollect what we have discussed. No, yes or no? Okay. So that's what. Now, can you able to say what are the thread life cycle? What are the phases you have in thread life cycle? Is it clear? Yes? Fine. Very good, Jagadish. Now, in the same way, as the thread is having the life cycle phases, even our applet is also having some of the life cycle stages. What are they? I'll tell you. There are five stages. The first one is this is the only program which is meant for discussing life cycle of the applet. This is not an executable program, only to discuss about the life cycle of an applet. Okay, so what is the first one? First one is init, that is init method. There is the initialization state. There is a state called initialization. That can be achieved through init method. So in the initialization will be happened through init method, and these two are one group, init and destroy. Okay, init method will initialize your applet and destroy method will destroy your applet. Yes or no? It just destroys your applet. And start method will resume your, start your execution. I'll tell you what is that. I'll tell you, don't worry. Start method will start your applet once again, and stop method will stops its execution. It suspends its execution. Start method resumes its applet's execution. Stop method suspends its execution. And whatever paint method is, suppose if you want to draw anything on your applet, applet means some window, I'll show you, don't worry, I'll show you everything. The paint method will be used to paint on your, not paint, paint means you want, if you want to draw something, suppose if you want to draw any oval, if you want to draw any string, if you want to draw any string on that is text on that. Suppose if you want to draw any rectangle, any arc, anything, then you have to use the paint method. Then that responsibility belongs to paint method. Okay or not? Yes or no? So these are the five stages you have in your applet: init and destroy, start and stop, and paint. Okay? And one thing, guys, please do remember, init and destroy will be called only once in its life cycle. Only once. Whenever an applet initializes first, then it will be called, init will be called. Whenever it just closes, then destroy will be called. So these two methods will be called for only once in their lifetime. Okay, understood, guys? Did you understand what I'm saying? Init and destroy will be called how many times in its life cycle? Only one time. Okay. And what about start and stop? Whenever this applet resumes any times, n number of times, that start method will be called. Along with the start method, whatever the things I have written, suppose this is an applet, suppose think this is, this window is an applet. Okay, I'll execute, then you'll understand. Suppose if I want to write something, that again it has to redraw, no? So paint method will be called along with your start method. Paint method will be called along with your start method to redraw the contents on the window, to redisplay the contents on the window. I'll tell you for sure. Don't worry, I'll execute the program, next program. Okay, so guys, did you understand, everybody? Did you understand this app one? Everyone, Satvika, Shravya, and Jagadish 68, that is Bhavani, Anil, Jagadish. Yes. Please keep them in your, please recollect whenever you come across with these applets, you just recollect these life cycle methods. Okay, what is this applet and all? Please look at this. There are two ways to execute your applets. Okay. One thing is through HTML file, .html. Do you know anything about HTML? Do you have at least some idea? Some idea of HTML? .html. HTML files. Yes or no? I'm sorry, this chat box is always... Okay, many of you have question. It's a hypertext marker plot. Exactly. So, after writing the applet code, after writing this class, you can accept this. After writing this class, entire thing, if you keep in, if you save that as a .html file, and if you click on, double click on that, then that applet will be executed. Then that applet will be displayed. Okay. Otherwise, the second way of executing your applet is using applet viewer tool. Okay. Understood? So how an applet viewer tool will recognize your applet is, this is what the code helps out. Okay, this code, whatever the code which is there in the comment section, that code will remind your applet viewer tool that it is telling that this is the code, this program is related to the applets. Applet viewer tool eppudaithe ee code ni meek program lo chustundo, then it will understand that the whatever the code you have written, that is meant for applets. Even in the comment section, of course, this is not just like a comment. This is not just like our regular comments. This the syntax is itself. The syntax is itself like that. Okay, understood. This is not just like comment. The compiler will not recognize this. But the applet viewer tool will recognize this section of code. Guys, did you understand what I'm saying? Yes or no? The applet viewer tool will recognize that this code is applet code. How it is going to recognize? Because of this code. What is there in this code? In this comments? Did you understand what is this? Whenever I keep something in the angular brackets, what does it mean? It's a tag, no? It's a tag, yes or no? H1 tag, H2 tag, like that you have some tags in within angular braces. So here, this applet is a tag. In that applet tag, what are these? Code, width and height. Code, width and height. Excellent. They are attributes. In our regular HTML tags, generally we will have font color, text align, something is called like image, img, source, src, yes or no? Font family, we have something, some attributes along with the tags, yes or no? In the same way, applet tag is taking the attributes like, code, width and height. Okay, what is code means whatever the code you have written here, what is the class name of this applet code here? App1. So that name you have to mention here. Okay, understood? And one more thing, how should be the applet window? There would be an applet window just like this. Just a second, I'll open this again. Okay. Where is this? Okay. See, this is an applet window. Suppose this is an applet window. Okay. The width and height of the applet window can be mentioned through your applet width and height attributes. Understood? What I'm saying, did you understand? Whatever the applet window, you can mention the width and heights here itself in the applet tag. Okay, so the width I just mentioned 300, the height I just mentioned as 100. That's how, it's our wish, it's our choice, you can choose anything. Okay, so next one more point I want to mention you here is, this paint method is not the part of applet class. exactly this method. This method is available from the graphics class. Listen carefully. Out of 5 life cycle methods, one of the method, paint method, is not available from the applet class, but it is available from the graphics class. Understood or not? So this paint method provides the object of graphics. This paint method will providing the object of graphics G. What is G? Object of type graphics. Very good. Object of type graphics. So with this GE object, I can able to draw anything. I can able to type the text. I can able to draw circle, oval, rectangle, square, arc, etc., etc. Okay, so, and one more point, the very important point I am telling you guys, that applet class must be a public class. The applet class must be a public class. Can you please tell me how, why so? The applet class must be a public class. Why? Because, listen carefully, actually this paint method, actually it is available from the graphics class. So this applet class should be available to the graphics, no? Because they are not under same package. This graphics class and the applet class are not under the same package. So as they are not in the same package, the both classes should be available, no? This applet class should be available for the graphics class. This graphics class should be available for the applet. So what I have to do? Until unless I declare this class as public, this class, applet class, is never available to your graphics class. Understood or not what I am saying? Can you able to recollect the concepts related to access specifiers? Two classes kanaka same packages lo lekapothe, what you have to do to make those available, to make those classes available, you have to declare them as public, no? Yes or no? So for sure you have to declare this applet class as public, otherwise you will be getting a warning or exception. Okay, not an exception, it's an error. Okay, understood or not? I'll ask you quickly a couple of questions, that is two or three questions I want to ask you guys. Applet class is available in which package? Quickly. Applet, very good. Graphics class is available in which package? Jagadish, graphics is a class, it's not a package. Graphics class available in AWT package. Here you can see, no? AWT is a package, applet is a package. Capital A is a class, capital A, applet is a class, capital G, graphics is a graphics class. Okay, now suppose how applet viewer tool will recognize your program is meant for applet class, applet thing? Because of applet viewer tool key, how it is going to understand that you are dealing with the applets. What is the code here meant for, which is meant for the no, I am talking about this. Exactly 72. What is your name, 72? What is your name? Yeah, exactly, Vishnu. See, this applet, because of this applet tag, the applet viewer tool will understand you are dealing with the applets. Okay? Then, I'll ask you some other question. How I can able to create an applet class? How I can create an applet class? Now you can tell me to extend from the applet. applet class ni ela create cheyagalthanu, how I can deal with the applet class, how I can able to create an applet class by extending from the applet, capital applet. Very good, excellent. And how many methods we have in the applet life cycle? Five. Out of five, what is the method which is available from the graphics class? Out of five, paint method. Paint method is taking which parameter? Which parameter? Paint method is graphics object. Very good. Super, super, excellent. Graphics object. And what are all the two methods we'll call only once in a unit's life cycle? ఏ రెండు మెథడ్స్ ఒక్కసారి ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ ఓన్లీ యూనిట్ శ్రావ్య యూనిట్ అండ్ డిస్ట్రాయ్ యూనిట్ అండ్ డిస్ట్రాయ్ విల్ బి కాల్డ్ ఓన్లీ వన్స్ ఇన్ దేర్ లైఫ్ సైకిల్ అండ్ స్టార్ట్ అండ్ స్టాప్ అండ్ స్టార్ట్ అండ్ స్టాప్ ఎన్నిసార్లు ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతాయి కెన్ యూ ఎబుల్ టు సే నో ఎన్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్స్ వెన్ ఎవర్ ద యాప్లెట్ రెజ్యూమ్స్ అగైన్ స్టార్ట్ విల్ బి కాల్డ్ whenever the whenever it suspends, stop method is going to be called and paint method is going to be called along with the start method. Endukante applet lo evaithe nen rastano that has to be redrawn again, redrawn. Okay, I'll show you, don't worry, I'll show you. So hope you everybody understood this, hope everybody understood. And one more thing, applet class must be declared as with what access specifier? Public. Excellent, excellent, very good. So the next one is see, now we are going to read the comment line, guys. Read the comment line first, everyone. Please read the comment line. A simple applet that sets the foreground and background colors and outputs the stream. Okay, we are just creating an applet here and that sets the foreground and background colors and also outputs the stream. It outputs the stream. Listen, already you know, you are aware of this through these things, how to import AWT. AWT is star or also AWT.graphics also, okay, no? Anything is okay, right? Yes or no? Yeah. Very good. And this must be right. This must be written for sure. Yes or no? To make aware of our applet, we are told that we are dealing with the applets. And here is the class app2 which extends from applet. And what I am doing is I want to create an applet. And on that applet, I want to print a string. I want to output a string. Okay, that is what my objective right now. Okay, see, how I am doing with the init, because in the init method, I just want to initialize what are all the things I want to initialize. In the init method, I want to initialize what are all the things I want to initialize. What I am initializing, I want to use the set background. I want to use the set background and set foreground methods, which are and that methods will take that color dot pink and color dot red. What is color here is, color is a class, color is also a class here, color is also a class, and the pink and red are the constants. Okay, they are the constants. Okay, color dot with this color class, I am calling the pink constant so that the background color must be pink, the foreground must be red. Okay, understood? And I am declaring one message. That is HEMA first here, and also this message I am concatenating with the one more string here in start method. We are only discussing three methods here: init, start, paint. Init, start, paint. Okay, see. And here in start method, whatever the message I just initialized here in the init method, that is to be concatenated with the that is to be concatenated with the one more message, that is bindu. And here in the paint method, I am concatenating with the one more string, that is string. So the entire message is right now is yes, exactly. Himo bindu sri, and along with that I am appending some spaces also. Okay, exactly. And some spaces also I am concatenating, so it will be considered. Okay, and the one thing important is on G, on the object of graphics method, graphics class, I am calling a method drawString method. DrawString method is taking three parameters. First one is the message which the string which I am going to draw on the applet, and the second one is the x-axis, that is the points they are related to the points x-axis, and 30 is related to the y-axis. Okay, x-axis and y-axis, understood? Height and width, it's not just like height and width. On x-axis, how much gap you have to leave. On y-axis, how much gap you have to leave to print this message. Okay, these are the coordinates. These are the coordinates I am mentioning to display this message. Understood? Understood, everybody? Yes? See, here, that's what actually. Shall I execute this? How we have to execute is, see, execution is a little different actually. But still, don't worry, we can able to, it is easy only. Just a second, give me a second to adjust these windows. Okay, how I am executing, please do understand very clearly. Okay, the work, what is the name of our applet? Apptu.java. Okay, right, it compiled very fine. Now how I need to run this program, it is different. Actually, how we will do in our console based applications, Java Apptu. But here what you need to do is you need to call your applet viewer space apptu.java. Okay. What happened? Applet viewer is not recognized an internal or external command operable program or bash file. Just give me a second. Actually, guys, hold on. Sorry, I just spelled wrongly. Viewer spelling is wrong. Exactly. Very good. Right? Is that fine right now? B-I-E-W-E-R. Okay? Now, see. I'm sorry. Restore down. I'll keep this applet on top of this because it would be very much clear, no? See, this is what the applet is created right now. Yes or no? This is the applet. Actually, this is what your applet. And what is your applet? The name of the applet is app2. Okay. And this is the title bar applet. Can you able to see my cursor? This is the title bar. And the below one is the status bar. Okay. Title bar and the status bar. And in between it is the container space on which you can able to display the contents of your applet. So can you able to see? So how many methods we have called right now? One thing, guys. Did I call any one of the method, init method or start method or paint method? Did I call any one of the methods? No. Yes or no? They are callback methods. Whenever, as and when you start your applet, the methods will be called automatically. Okay, the methods will be called automatically. And if you observe, guys, did I write any main method here? No, there is no point of main method in the applets. There is no entry point of just like main. There is nothing like that. Okay, so here how many methods got executed as based on our output? Hima, Bindu, Sri means three methods: init method, start method, and also paint method also got executed. Yes or no? Now please do understand clearly. I'll minimize this. I just minimized and I'll maximize this once again. Please look at that. Then again, what happened? After Hima, Bindu, Sri, again, what was called again? What methods called again? Okay, Bindu, Sri is correct, but I am asking about methods. Start and paint. Because after minimizing, if I minimize this, the stop method will be called. Of course, we did not override here. Stop method ni manam ikkada override cheyaledu kabatti dantlo em jarugutund anedi we couldn't able to see, but still if I minimize, the stop method will be called. Again if I maximize, the start method will be called along with the paint method, because the content should be redrawn again. Understood? If I minimize, stop method will be called. If I maximize, start method will be called along with the paint method. And if I close, what method is going to be called? Close the app. Very good. Super. Excellent. That is destroy method is going to be called. Okay. Destroy method is going to be called finally. Understood? One thing, guys, the 10 is this. The 10 here, there is a space from one more thing. The applet always it consider the coordinates from 0, 0 is top left corner, exactly on which I have kept the cursor. No, let me take this. So here it is 0, 0. Here it is 0, 0. Top left corner is 0, 0. And from here it is 10. 10 means 10 points. Okay. That is on x-axis. This is x-axis. Okay. This is x-axis horizontally. And this is y-axis. On y-axis it is 30. Understood? Are you able to understand this, guys? 10 and 30. On x-axis it is 10 and on y-axis it is 30. And the message is going to be printed on the respective coordinates. Yes, sir. Okay, guys, understood everybody how this these are the things related to the applet? Yes or no? Understood or not? Everyone, clear? Yeah, very good. Yeah, guys, hope you understood this point. Hope you understand this program, right? Yes or no, everyone, right? So shall we discuss the, did I close this applet? Did I close this applet? I have to close this applet, okay? See. Read the comment line, guys. Read the comment line first. Read the comment line, please. Comment line. Read everyone. We're using the status window. How to use the status window? Okay. How to use the status window? So on status window, what we can able to do? That's what we are going to discuss right now. Okay, see, I hope everybody know this. Everybody know this. And public class app3 extends applet. So this is the name of the applet. Here is app3, and here we have init method. In that init method, we just have set the background. That is cyan color. Color dot cyan is something like something. Okay, some shade of the color. And the paint method, in the paint method, what we have done is we just call the drawstring method. In the drawstring method, what we have drawn the text, hello KMIT, hello KMIT, and show status. I want to show some status, especially on my choice. What is that status? Hello second CSED students. Hello second year CSED students. That's what I want to make. I want to change something on my status bar. Okay, only that is only that thing is going to be different right now. Okay, shall we execute this? Show status is a method which can able to show some status of your applet. Okay, based on your interest. Okay. Okay, and what happened? The text, the string on the applet is hello KMIT. Okay, the string on the applet is hello KMIT, and the status you can able to see. What is the status we have on the status bar? I already told you, this is the status bar. Hello second year CSET students. That is the status bar, the text I want to print on the status bar. Okay, this is how you can able to do. Understood now? Yes or no? Okay, right? Guys, understood all app3 program? App3. Did everyone understood the app3? Finally, it is app4. That is along with the applet creation, I want to use the parameters. I want to use the parameters. Okay, what are the parameters I want to use? Have a look at this. Listen, you read the comment line first. Read the comment line. That is, we want to use some parameters. How to use some parameters here in the applet program? Okay, see, we will talk about swings and differences between AWT and swings a bit in the next class. Don't worry. Okay, see, this is what the code related to the app, which is meant for the applet viewer too. And there is a class called app4 which extends from japlet. Actually, this japlet, whenever we want to, applet is related to AWT. Okay, applets are related to AWT. If you want to use swings, then what you have to do, it is, the class name is japlet. Both are almost similar, but the japlet, what exactly the difference is, I'll tell you in the next class through some table. Okay, understood? So if you want to use the applet program, if you want to create the applet program through swings, then what you have to do, you have to extend from japlet instead of applet. Okay, there is a string name. Okay, in the start method, what I am doing is, there is a method called get parameter. Okay, get parameter method through that. And one more thing, guys, in the applet tag, we have one more thing is param. Okay, through this, the applet can understand there are some parameters we are able to pass. So what is there? It is just like a key value pairs. The parameters are just like a key value pairs. The key is the username and the value is Shravya. Okay, key is the username and the value is Shravya. Suppose if I use in the start method get parameter of username, then what would be the value will be stored in name? Can you please tell me? What would be the value is to be stored in the name? Exactly, Shravya. That is get parameter of username. If I give the associated value of username will be stored in name. Yes or no? And suppose if the name is null. If the name is null means, suppose if the key, if I did not mention the proper key, then what would be your name? Nenu oka proper key ivvaledu anukondi. Username ki badlu, suppose if I give like this. Then the name would be null, no? Here it would be null, no? Yes or no? Because I don't have this key. I did not mention it in these parameters. Yes or no? Then it would be null. So what is going to happen if the name is null? Then what happens? The name I want to store is KMIT. And in the paint method, again I am using g.drawstring method. So here that username, here from here to here, it is going to print as it is. Username plus, what is the name you have to give? Here, you already, as you have key, the Shravya is going to be printed here. And the coordinates which you are mentioning are 40 and 70. That is x axis 40 and y axis is 70. Okay, understood? Guys, did you understood? Let me execute this once. We did not set any background colors and the foreground colors, no? That's why it is plain. Understood, no? Did you understand the difference between the previous applet and the present applet? Yes or no? Yes, because we did not set any foreground and background colors. Set background color, set foreground color. We did not do that. Okay, so the username is now Shravya and the status bar is applet started. Okay, right. So guys, did you understand clearly how to use the parameters, if you want to use any parameters to your applet, how to make use of the life cycle methods? Did you understand? Yes or no? Right? Okay. So we have some knowledge related to what is an applet, what is the container, what are all the components we used to have, and what are the life cycle methods, how to execute the applet. So these are the things we have learned here in this session. Yes or no? So we have only 10 minutes, I think, 10 or 15 minutes. Actually, I want to give you two tasks today. Let me discuss first one task. Okay, one task I want to discuss. First one is, guys, hope you understood today's concept, I think. Yes or no? You can read the text based on this introduction and all. This is enough. Okay, we will continue in the next session. Okay, some event handling, event handlers, we will discuss in the next class. Okay, understood? Right? Yes or no? Yeah. So far we have discussed some of the lab tasks. No, from those, if we have time, we will cover. Otherwise, from those tasks only, I will conduct lab internal. Whatever the programs I have covered in the lab manual, I'll consider those programs only for your lab internal. So don't worry. Is that okay? Yes. Right. Understood. Yeah. See, this is the program actually. Okay. Just a second. Just give me a second, guys. I want to give you some other program right now. Some other program. Apart from this, I want to explain one more thing. Look at this program, please. Look at this program. Have a look at this. See, write a Java program to convert Roman numerals to decimals. Your job is to find out the Roman numerals to decimals. Okay. Understood, no? Understood? See, Roman numerals are based on the below symbols. So, if this is the symbol I, then what is the value? The appropriate decimal value is 1. And if it is I, that is IV, then it is 4. And if it is 5, then if it is V, then it is 5. It is meant for 5. This is X. IX is 9. X is 10. XL is 40. L is 50. XC is 90. C is 100. Okay, guys, if you clearly observe, and C is 100, CD is 400, D is 500, CM is 900, and M is 1000. Okay, if you clearly observe, I'll tell you one thing. X is 10 and L is 50. But if I place XL, that is, the first symbol is less than the second symbol, then what does it mean? The first symbol X is less than the L or not? The first symbol L, then we need to subtract. Understood, no? Did you understand this? Did you understand this? Okay. See, here the example is XC VI. That means X means 10 and immediately after x we have c. What is c? C is 100. Then xc is, that is the index 0, the value at the index 0 is less than the, if it is less than the index 1, the value at the index 1, then you have to subtract. Now again we will move to the index 2 and index 3. Yes or no? I hope you know the, you can able to relate these things to the, can you please tell me the indexes? This is 0th index, yes or no? This is 1st index, this is 2nd, this is, just give me a second. Is that fine? Right? Now this is the last index is 3. Yes or no? Anagada. 0, 1, 2, 3. The indexes are 0, 1, 2, 3. The index, the value at the index 0 is less than the value at the index 1, then you have to subtract. Else means what? If the first index is not less than the second index, you have to add. Suppose if you take V and I, the first index, that is the value at the index 2 is not less than the value at the index 3. Yes or no? Index 3. So what you have to do? You need to do subtraction or addition? Addition. So guys, did you understand now? So you have to check whether the first index is less than the second index, then you have to subtract. Otherwise, you have to add. You have to do addition. And so what is the value here? Till here it is 90 plus 90 plus, from here to here, what is this? Vi is 6, 5 plus 1, 6. So 90 plus 6, what is that? 96. That's how we got the output, no? Understood? One more clue I am giving you guys. Suppose if you are iterating through the entire string, this is a string, no? If you are iterating to the entire string, meeru ith the index ni, suppose I, when I int I is equal to 0th index ni consider chestunnaru ante, I plus 1 ni kuda consider chestunnaru, because you are comparing with the I plus 1 index. If I is equal to 0, you have to compare with the I plus 1 index. Yes or no? So, kani next iteration ko chedapadiki for loop lo malli em avutadi? For loop lo I is equal to 0 kasta, what it is going to do? Already comparison ikkada varaku aipothundi. Eppudu? First iteration lone. In the first iteration itself, 0th index and first index will be covered. Yes or no? Array of 0 and array of 1 is going to be covered. Yes or no? Yes. Adhe kaani for loop lo next time ki I value 1 avutadi. Avuna kada? I will be incremented to 1, from 0 to 1. Kabatti again for loop is considering array of I means array of 1 and array of 2. Yes or no? Actually for loop lo ila chestundi. Yes or no? Kaani idi already cover ayipoyindi kada first iteration lone. Kabatti within the for loop nu meer malli em cheyali? I plus plus cheyali. Very good. Excellent, Shravya. Excellent. That is, ardhamaindi kada. First iteration lone nenu rendu complete chesesanu kabatti for loop lo you have to write once again I plus plus so that next iteration you have to start with 2. Yes or no? 2 and 3. In the next iteration these two will be covered. Area of I and area of I plus 1. That is area of I is 2 and area of I plus 1 is 3 then. In the second iteration I am talking about. Guys, did you understand this or not? Is it confused? Are you, is it giving you any confusion? Is it clear? Clear or not? Clear? Shravya, understood. 72 also. And still 68. The remaining students, please, can you please respond? How to define these symbols? These symbols ki values etla define cheyali? See here. See, sorry, here like this you have to return. See, there is a method, value method. In this method you have to return the appropriate values of the Roman symbols. Suppose if the symbol is I, then you have to return 1. If the symbol is V, then you have to return 5. Yes or no. So this method you have to use, make use of the actual code. This method you have to make use. Yeah, Anil, I'll explain once again. Where did you left? Because from there I need to explain. Can you please tell me, Anil? From the starting. Okay, I'll explain once again, Mr. Anil. Just hold on. See, guys, remaining students, I'll come to you within a couple of seconds. Okay, don't worry. Remaining students, please do understand, this is the value method we have defined here to return the appropriate decimal values of your Roman symbols. Yes or no? If you have given any symbol apart from I, V, X, L, C, D, M, then you have to return minus 1 at last. Then you have to return minus 1. Okay. And in the Roman to decimal method, you have to take that string. This is the string we have to take, okay? And that string you have to traverse, yes or no? And in S1 is the value, the value at caret i, that is if i plus 1 is less than string dot length, that is we are checking with the length. If I am doing i plus 1, you have to check with the length. If it is so, I plus 1 is within the range, then what you have to do? You have to take the value of S2 also. That is, see, X ki value tisukunanu, C kuda value tisukunanu ikkada, is two statements lo, yes or no, did you understand that? Okay, what is the value I'll be getting from the value method? X is 10 and the x plus 1 is c is 100. Okay, now I am checking if s1 is less than s2. If s1 is less than s2, that means s1 is what? 10. 10 is less than 100 or not? Yes or no? 10 is less than 100 or not? Yes, so that what you have to do? You have to subtract. Okay. You have to subtract S2 minus S1. That is 100 minus S1. That is 90. You have to append that to the result. and again you have to increment I plus plus. Increment I plus plus means now you will be coming to the V. Okay, now you will be coming to the V. Okay, understood or not? XC is over. Now you have to consider V and I. Okay, else you have to add it. Else you have to add that S1. S1 to the result. If it is not less than the S1 is not less than the S2, then you have to add directly. You need not subtract. Okay? Understood? And finally, if it is not less than the string, what are all the remaining characters? Suppose if I'm having still I'll be left over with I. Then again, what you have to do? You have to concatenate with the S1 with the result. Guys, did you understand or not? Did you understand what we have to do? Anil, did you understand? Did you understand this? XC and VI? Yes? Initially, you have to check. Let me erase this. Then you will understand. Suppose if X is less than the C, then you have to subtract. If V is greater than the I, so you have to add these two. Okay? Understood, no? If the index is zero, the value at the index zero is less than the value of the index one, then you have to subtract. If the value at this index is greater than this value, then you have to add. That's what. And please make sure you have to use these like this. You have to have a method like this so to return the appropriate decimal values of your Roman symbols. Understood, everyone? Understood? Yes or no? These are the test cases. These are the test cases you have to draw. Let me start the task first. Let me start.